The playoff battle in the West starts off with a bang right here. Game one. Joined in the booth with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan. Our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. It's the Los Angeles Clippers facing the NBA champion, Golden State Warriors. You look at Golden State, so important in a seven-game series to maintain the home court advantage. The fans, the players, the coaches, guys, they know it's all on the line.
And, well, other than Game 7, I think Game 1 is the most important game of the series. For them as a home team especially, lose this game, and then there goes home court advantage.
And before we get going, let's hear from David Aldridge on the sideline. David?
Hey there, Kevin. Well, we all know that Steve Kerr, the Warriors coach, has a great way with his players. He said they see through all the BS. They've got to know that you're in charge and know what you're talking about. In the end, it's about them. Kevin?
You know what? That humble approach goes a long way, David. Thank you. To start out. And the Clippers starting five. Gallinari is out there with Ivica Zubac. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's Gilgeous Alexander in at the one spot. Green passes to Thompson. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. Thompson's got the first points up on the board for the Warriors. There's the pass to Zubac. Clippers moving the ball around. And it's Durant with the rebound.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
Inside. Out to Thompson. Over Beverley. The shot by Thompson, no good. And it's the Clippers ball. Shamet. No good on the triple. To the inside, Green. Nice pass, right under the rack, perfectly for the layup. Green's got his first basket of the night. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Misses the three. The Warriors have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Beverley against Thompson. Off target from three-point range. The Clippers have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Los Angeles with another miss.
I'm not sure if it's a bad start or unlucky here. 0-4. Can't think too much about it. Just got to get that first one to go.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points. But the D, just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Shamet, defended by Durant. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here, and he's good on the three ball. Gallinari's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. And here's Curry, who brings it up for the Golden State Warriors. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Here's Durant. Buries it down low.
And I ask you, what can you do? This guy is a phenomenal decision maker.
Passes it to Zubac. To the inside. Green with the rebound. Warriors leading by 3. Outside for Curry. Back to Thompson. From 13. No good from Durant.
Not a lot of defense there. You can't afford to let guys shoot freely from the mid-range. They're not going to miss those all that often.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
The Warriors shooting their first free throws of this game.
shooting two.
First free throw is good.
Draymond Green is a great role player on the offensive end on the floor and makes guys around him better because he's willing to make plays and passes. And then he's got that commitment, that tenacity on the defensive end as well.
Both free throws good from Green. Clippers trail by five. Beverly with the ball. He kicks to Temple. Five on the clock. With some arc, and it's good on the way up.
And it's all about the release when you shoot the floater.
Inside, and it's Green missing.
And I really thought he was going to send that shot the other way, but at least he forces the miss.
Well, just good timing on his part. Anytime the shooter has to adjust, the defense wins.
And here are the Warriors now. Clippers able to drain the three. Curry looking it over. Drains the three-pointer. Curry's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
I don't know what you do with Steph in the pick-and-roll situation like that. He capitalizes because of the separation, and it doesn't have to be much.
Now here's Williams. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. A shot by Thompson, and no one's around. A three-pointer, no good. And so Beverly will bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. It's a three-point game. 1:19 left here in the first quarter. There's Gallinari with the three. It's rebounded by Golden State. Thompson for the triple. Gallinari with the rebound. Gallinari's got five rebounds tonight.
Yeah, his shot just doesn't seem to be synced up right now. Here's hoping he finds it soon because his team is really going to need that production tonight.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
The Clippers shooting their first foul shots of the night here. The first one falls, and the Warriors with a completely new five on the floor. And the Clippers making a change here as well. Green, he's checked in for Patrick Beverly. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. 52 seconds left to play in the first. Iguodala kicks to Livingston. Pass to Jurepko. Golden State moving it around. Iguodala, the pass to Cook. To the left wing. Here's Livingston. That shot missing. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Here's Gallinari. It's good from the top of the key. Gallinari's got 5 points so far.
Nice swing action there. Gallo, he simply squares up and rises to the occasion.
Cook looking it over. And again, it's the Warriors missing. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. The Clippers on top, leading by just one. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Oracle Arena in Oakland, California. Steph Curry talks about the visual drills he does to help his playmaking. as he's made the transition from a point guard at Davidson to a combo guard in the NBA.
It's a cognitive and neurological drill that helps you, one, takes your mind off the basketball, because when you're in a game, that should be the last thing you're thinking about. There's so many other variables out there that you have to kind of survey, you know, where your defender is, where your teammates are, where you are in relation to the basket and your reaction. So those lights kind of train you in that regard. You have to, you know, see what the color is, make a determination of what move that corresponds to, execute the move, and then finish the jumper.
The improvement he's made, Greg, in his ball handling has really unlocked his game.
I mean, able to keep his head up as he attacks off the dribble, read the defense, and drills like that can only help.
And we welcome you back to our presentation of Game 1. And guys, what's your take on the Clippers so far?
A huge fan of how they have rotated here defensively, been able to challenge multiple shots.
And if you're rotating like that, it's got to be a great line of communication between all five guys. You see that reflected on the scores, all that trust showing up with the lead.
We've got Iguodala, Jonas Jerebko out there with Looney, and there's Livingston, and it's Cook in at the one. That's the group for the Golden State Warriors to start the second quarter. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill. And guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, G.A. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting them get all the way to the basket that time.
Well, we talk about the D. Let's credit the offense. He attacked right there from the moment he saw the opening, not letting the defense react.
Here is Cook. After the basket by Montrezl Harrell, Livingston kicks to Cook. Here's the floater. Jerebko and the three off target.
And that's a rare sight. Usually shooters make the defense pay when they're that lackadaisical.
And there's the pass to Temple. Now here's Harrell. He's covered by Iguodala. Warriors trail by four. Kicks to Jerebko. And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession.
And this is where you have to sharpen up your passing. That's a careless turnover.
Gilgeous Alexander's checked in for the Clippers. Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in. Harrell finds Green. The kick out to Williams. Shot is good off the back rim and in. Williams has got 5 points in the quarter.
Well, it's such a challenge trying to alter anything that Lou Williams does just because you're on your heels most of the time.
Here's Livingston. And again, it's the Warriors missing. Clippers leading by six. Feeds to Green. And the rejection by Iguodala.
Iguodala demonstrating his defensive prowess yet again. Superb reach on that block.
Livingston, that's good.
This is where you want the shots to come from. Deep inside the paint and high percentage opportunities.
Pass to Green. Outside Williams. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. To the middle. Here's Harrell. And it's Looney with the rebound.
And his touch has just been a little bit absent this quarter. And he's missing a ton of shots.
Livingston, and he drops it in from the low post. And now, just a 2-point Clipper lead.
Got to stay with Livingston. The D cannot let him dice them up with his handle.
Harrell dishes to Williams. Back to Harrell. And Looney sends it back. And here comes Livingston, leading the fast break. Iguodala kicks to Cook. Back to Iguodala. And there's the defensive 3-second call. The Warriors shooting their third free throw attempt of the game.
Find the lane. Find the lane.
One shot.
That's good from Yarebko. Different look here for the Warriors. DeMarcus Cousins is checked in for Looney. Kevin Durant comes in for Andre Iguodala. Klay Thompson is checked in for Sean Livingston. And Curry subbed in for Cook. Los Angeles on D. Here's Durant. And good as it just snugs right down through the net.
Well, that's a smart shot by KD. Sizes up the D and then just cashes in.
Shamet defended by Durant. Here's Zubats. Second shot opportunity. Warriors with the rebound.
Wonderful defense, staying active around the rim and then really putting the shooter in a tough spot.
The Clippers trail. Down low. Shamet. And Durant sends it back.
Wow, the large wingspan of Durant on full display. What a block there.
1:24 left in the second quarter. Thompson for three. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in.
Oh, great ball movement there.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
Yeah, it looked like they tried to shoot their way out of the slump, and that didn't work. They got to go back and regroup.
Well, no matter how hard it's been, you want to stay positive, stay focused, and maybe a couple shots will get you right back in it.
Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. .119 left in the first half of basketball. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. No points in the game yet for him. To halt the run, and he makes that one.
What a play there. The hoop plus the harm.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
One shot, find the lane.
On the free throw, no good. It's stolen by Green. That's short off the rim.
A bad shot there. Trust is lacking. You got to be willing to make the extra pass.
Yeah, just too anxious to try and make something happen out there. This is about the team, not about you.
And the Clippers have possession. After the three-pointer from Klay Thompson, Durant kicks to Curry. And the jumper off target to finish the break.
I think what I'd like to see from him in this quarter is getting going from the perimeter. Hit a three in the first, nothing in the second.
24 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Shamet, defended by Durant. Five on the clock. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Shoots over Curry. Gilgeous Alexander, good. Gilgeous Alexander's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Where was the D on that one? Just too easy.
Curry way outside. Another three for Golden State.
Good shot selection there from Steph, feeling the rhythm and then easily connecting on the pull-up.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been active and effective. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Alongside Steve Kerr and Coach, what is the offensive approach going to be in the second half?
Well, we just have to do what we do, move the ball and wear them down with our ball movement, our cutting and our spacing and set better screens, all the usual stuff.
Yeah, it always seems to work out for you in the long run. Thanks, Steve. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Well, there's a definite postseason buzz in the air. Welcome back, everybody. Ernie Johnson, Kenny Smith, and Shaquille O'Neal. Well, for Golden State, they've put themselves in decent shape to grab that all-important Game 1 victory. So far, they've clearly been the better team controlling the flow. By no means is it a runaway, but they've put themselves in a great position. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
Well, I think they're feeling the energy of this hometown crowd. Sometimes you get a little complacent and comfortable in your surroundings, but no, they fed off adrenaline in the first half.
And over to Shaq, now your take on the Clippers.
Well, one thing happened that really helped them out. Their bench came in and played absolutely beautiful. Gave them a huge boost. Not just trying to hold court, but actually putting points on the scoreboard. These guys should be starting, Ernie.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
As we return to the action here at Oracle, a terrific look from above at downtown Oakland and the historic Tribune Tower. And welcome back to the NBA playoffs as we get ready to continue with this round one matchup. Klay Thompson with a strong contribution so far in this one.
And how about the opening half of basketball he played? I mean, so much riding on this game, and he came out with a sense of urgency to start.
Yeah, proving that this moment for him is really not that big a deal, something we already know. Expect them to lean on him heavily down the stretch.
Welcome back as we get set to continue our coverage of this round one playoff matchup. Clippers trail by six. And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. So for the Clippers right now, Gilgeous Alexander out there with Patrick Beverly. Then there's Gallinari. Then it's Ivica Zubac. Now here's Curry. They get it back. Outside for Durant. No good with the triple.
Well, it's like the defense has a bunch of matchbooks in their hands right now, playing with fire. We were fortunate that somehow he misfired on that one.
14 feet away, and the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. That's 10 points for Klay Thompson. And Los Angeles guys shooting 32% overall right now, not one of their better showings. Here's Zubac on the mark with the 15-footer. Zubac has got his first 2 points.
Nice job operating in the mid-range, using his size advantage to rise up and fire over the defender.
Thompson passes to Cousins. Count it. Cousins has got the lead up to 8 now for the Warriors.
Well, there's a lot of moves that Cousins can go with on the inside. If he doesn't back you down, he's got a fadeaway and a step back. Tough to guard on the interior.
Gallinari in the corner. No good on the three. And here's Curry, who brings it up for Golden State. They lead by 8. That's the biggest of the game. And Durant gets it to go.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Los Angeles calls timeout. Some changes here for the Warriors. Kevon Looney comes in for DeMarcus Cousins, and it's Iguodala in for Thompson. Here's Harrell, and a miss there off the inbound.
And they've only connected on 1 of 4 to start the half. Their offense is sputtering just a little bit here.
Green finds Iguodala. Some nice passing by Golden State here. And that's a foul called on Gallinari. That's foul number two for him. Sean Livingston, he's checked in for Curry. Here is Livingston. And that one goes long. Clippers trail by 10. Williams passes to Harrell. And Harrell slams it in.
Such an effective combo guard. We all know that Lou Williams can score. But once he gets going, he'll set a teammate up too.
Iguodala dishes to Durant. Over Gallinari. And the Warriors miss again. The Clippers have gone 2 of 5, shooting here in the third quarter. Here's Temple, defended by Durant. There's the lob to the hoop. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. Pulls up. Green breaking loose. And it's good off the back rim and in. And it's 8 points for Kevin Durant.
Good anticipation there from Iguodala, who is a very good passer.
Williams kicks to Gallinari. Harrell. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up. This is his second trip to the free throw line.
Gentlemen, 2 shots. Roof shots.
No good on the free throw. And the Warriors making a change here. Cook's checked in. He sinks the second. Here is Livingston. Third quarter action and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Passes it to Looney. Poked loose. Stolen by Beverly. And here we go. Fast break. Beverly's got it. Shoots over Livingston. Nice spin off the left rim and in. Beverly's got 5 points so far.
Good route there from Beverly in transition. So quick and then really decisive on his line to the basket.
Outside Durant, the three. The offensive rebound. Here's Livingston. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. He has 6.
This is where you got to put a body on the guy. His will is incredible down on the interior, fighting and clawing for every rebound.
Williams kicks to Temple. Gallinari in the corner. Over Durant. Got it. And the Warrior lead has been cut down to 7 on the bucket from Gallinari.
Sweet shot from Gallo. So many ways he can hurt you.
Here is Cook. Gallinari covering. Durant with a wide open look. Buries the long range jumper. Durant's got 7 points for the quarter.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
And the Clippers call time here.
Yeah, it looked like they tried to shoot their way out of the slump, and that didn't work. They got to go back and regroup.
Well, no matter how hard it's been, you want to stay positive, stay focused, and you know, maybe a couple shots will get you right back in it.
And the Warriors with some changes. DeMarcus Cousins is checked in for Kevon Looney. Yurebko comes in for Andre Iguodala. Lance Thompson in for Cook. Outside Williams. 105 left in the third quarter of the game. Count it. Williams has got 7 points in the game.
And after an abysmal first half from the field, the shots now starting to fall.
Here's Livingston, and it's Golden State with another.
Great form on the Livingston jump shot there. He knows he's got the green light in the mid-range.
Clippers trail by 10. Pass to Harrell. And stolen by Cousins. And up the court come the Warriors on the break. Rebound by Harrell. The Clippers have gotten 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field. Warriors leading by 10. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Left side Durant lets it go from deep. Gilgeous Alexander pulls it in. Los Angeles has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Rebounded by Yurebko.
That's a wide, wide open shot. Sadly, he came up short.
Here's Durant. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. 13 points for Kevin Durant.
I mean, what a talent this guy is. Durant has the ability to score from anywhere and now picking his spots.
And that's just a risky play to make a heave like that. Not worth it.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break. They've excelled in the open court. Their transition game has allowed them to build this healthy lead. We've got more in store for you right after this. And a moment ago, inside the huddle with head coach Steve Kerr.
Defense has been fantastic. Great defense, offense, simple passes will get it done, right? You guys look great, though. Keep the pressure on.
Paying his guys respect they deserve. Likes what he sees. I like that message.
And, Kevin, it's so important to praise your guys when they're playing well. Coach understands how critical it is to recognize good effort.
And welcome back to the NBA playoffs as we get ready to continue with this round one matchup. And it's all 5 All-Stars out there for the Warriors. Curry, Klay, Durant, Green, and Cousins. So that's the group out there for Golden State. Now here's Durant. Here's Cousins. Uses the glass to finish the layup. And the Warriors lead by 16.
Up by a bunch. He's still pushing the action, trying to impose his will.
Well, collectively, they've done it tonight here. A passionate performance from the squad.
Williams can't get it to go.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game. Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark.
Well, this has been a night where you can look at his shooting and his performance, and it's affected the team. That's the bottom line.
It's good. 6 points here for Cousins.
And it's been about that execution offensively. I mean, they have been superb.
Yeah, they're just absolutely getting anything and everything that they want out there. They have not let up.
Now here's Williams. 6 to shoot. Over in the corner, Zubats. Can they get it? And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Green's got 6 rebounds here tonight.
I've not seen him shoot this poorly, guys, in a game this season.
Now here's Williams, following the shot by Kevin Durant. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Shamet. Good on the triple.
He can be just lethal from the perimeter. Even though he didn't get good looks in the first quarter, will that make right there? That could change things.
Here's Thompson. He's off on that one. Clippers trail by 18. Shamet, defended by Durant. Outside, Green. A pass to Williams. Over Curry. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Green's got 7 rebounds in the game.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat. Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
And I like this timeout. You're getting terrible rim protection right now.
Well, you got to ask your team to give you a little bit more effort because there's just not a lot of fire on the defensive end.
And now we get the chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Kevin Durant.
And I would point to his shooting percentage as the key reason he's our pick. And that sounds simple, but he hadn't tried to do too much. He hasn't tried to force his shots, just kind of waited and worked to get good looks. And in the end, he's found plenty of them.
You know, that's how you send a message to open a series. There's always one player who's the difference maker in the playoffs. And I think we found our man. It's stolen by Curry. From deep three-point range, and it's the Clippers with the rebound.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
Shamet. No good with the triple.
Might want to stop shooting from out there right now because it's just not working. He needs to look to get his teammates involved at this point in the game.
Curry against Gallinari, and he gets the bucket. Curry's got 5 points in the quarter.
Yeah, this is demoralizing, I think, for a defense. You want Steph to score on the interior, but that's too easy.
Kicks it to Beverly. We've got 1:55 left in the fourth quarter. 5 on the clock. Takes a 3. No good on that one. Good D by Thompson. Here's Golden State now. They're on a 13-3 run. Now here's Curry. Pass to Cousins. His 3-pointer is off the mark.
A tremendous boost for these guys as this game winds down and what will be a win here in game 1 of the series for the Warriors.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget, and on the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And as one might have guessed coming into this game, it was indeed another big game tonight for Kevin Durant.
And he was remarkable. Absolutely destroyed the opposition. Any matchup he had tonight, it felt like he was going to dominate.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander, the Warriors making the shot. There's 48 seconds left to play here in the fourth. And the slam dunk by Iguodala.
And saving their best for last. Tremendous run here to seal the win.
And you could just see everything coming together like a perfect storm, and they just rolled on through.
Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Knocked loose. And here's Gallinari outside. Doesn't get it to drop for him. The Warriors go the other way with it. And guys, they can just sit on the ball here if they want to.
They have earned this win.
About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Cousins inside. Zubac defending. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. So we see the Warriors taking the game here. A pretty good feeling right now for them to be out in front like this in the series.
You know, Kevin, momentum so critical. And you know they'll want to ride this wave into game two.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Kevin, how did you guys get this win tonight?
Well, we had to get stops. You know, those guys, they got so many options, so many good players, man. We just had to rally around each other and get stops.
Yeah, you guys played your best ball at the end and got the win. Congratulations. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that about wraps it up, folks. We hope you've enjoyed our broadcast of the NBA Western Conference quarterfinals. So for David Aldridge, Craig Anthony, Brent Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. So long, everyone.